Hello, friends, and welcome to our soundcheck video. We've had to make a few adjustments to how we do business, so I've had to shuffle a few members of my staff around to make sure that people are within my bubble.
Dad, is this where I do the hold the strings on? Give my brother the
guitar. Hey, could I have my per diem? Tell my mama not to worry
about money quite so much. And pirouette. Now your turn, Steven. Never turn your back upon a second
chance. Never trust a guy. I am trying to hit the high E. Yes, I've been doing my warm-ups.
Hopefully you can see me and you can hear me. In which case, we're ready to roll.
Hey, Dad, it's almost time for the show. Cause the ceiling gonna shatter. And believe me when it does.
Those who pin it to the margins, baby, they'll be sweeping up.
Good evening. Oh, there's my light. That was kind of weak. You're going to have to do better for the artists when they come on. That's my only request, okay? All right, thank you. My name is Brett Elliott. I'm the executive director here at the Kate. And welcome back. We are so glad to have you. It was a long time that we were closed, but we are so glad that you're here. So we don't have a brochure printed yet. Normally I'd hold that up right now, but thekate.org has everything that's upcoming. The July-August brochure is printing, and if you get that, it will come to your mailboxes in about a week. You can also fill out one of these cards. They're all over the lobby, and we'll make sure you get one in your mailbox as well, but thekate.org has everything. Camps, wanted to mention camps as well. If you have children in your life, Kate's Camp for Kids still has a few slots open, very few, for 6 weeks this summer. So check that out. There are brochures downstairs as well. If you're a member of the Kate, I want to say thank you. You're the reason that we were able to get through the 15 months that we were closed. So just thank you so much. And if you're not, membership is the way that the Kate keeps doing all the great things they do, and it's the best way to support us. So consider joining us if you like what happens here. I want to thank our sponsors as well. So the Andre Prost Company is our lead sponsor. They're a Taste of Thai, Zatz Candies, Honey's Cough Drops, and other products. Pasta Vita Gourmet to go over on Elm Street, the Saybrook Point Resort and Marina, the Gowrie Group Insurance Experts over in Westbrook, Guilford Savings Bank, For All Gifts and For All Promos, and Ameriprise Financial, Coburn Financial Group. Do want to give a shout out to the back of the ticket sponsor. It currently says the Red Hen on your tickets. They didn't make it through the pandemic. We missed them. But the Penny Lane Pub and Sip together will be our new back of the ticket sponsor starting on July 1, so we're giving them a little shout out early. That brings us to this evening. No intermission. We are going to go straight through. It'll be a bit over 90 minutes because we're also streaming this show this evening, or Steven's team is, and so we're going straight through. Bar will stay open for the first 30 to 45 minutes or so. Doors at the back will get you down to the first level if you need the restrooms or the bar. If you'd shut your phones off, we would so appreciate that. And I think that's all I've got. Oh, thanks for bearing with all of our construction as well. We appreciate it. There's a lot going on, but a lot of good things coming. I'm just doing a soft start here. It's going to start in just a moment. They've got to get all the cameras queued really fast. We'll be underway in just a moment. So sit back, relax, and enjoy.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Stephen Kellogg, and I'm here at an undisclosed location.
Well, we'll start with the man who we are always happy to welcome back on the mountain stage. This is his sixth visit.
Really excited. Stephen Kellogg is with
us. Singer-songwriter Stephen Kellogg has shared a few things.
It does.
Back in the day, you used to do 275 days a year on the road.
Studios with Stephen Kellogg.
I'd never heard your music before. I really loved it.
The thing is, I have been kicking around here for almost 20 years now, you know. I know what you're
saying. He does what he does best, which is mine his own life to come up with some truths. Paul Simon does it too. A lot of great writers do it, and I think he's right up there with them. I'm not a guy that keeps
up. I never give up. Sold out show tonight at Wolf Trap. Please welcome our friend, Stephen Kellogg.
Please welcome Mr. Stephen Kellogg.
My name is Stephen Kellogg, professional singer and songwriter. It's better to be at the bottom of a ladder you want to climb than the top of one you don't. I got that from The Office. There'll be objects
in the mirror. I think Stephen is brave, you know, so as an artist, he's an artist's artist. As we look back
through the love. The most honest music I've ever listened to in my life. It's like he's writing in his diary. Gotta dance like a
symphony of joy. In his music, he exudes optimism, a belief in all our abilities to transcend and persevere. I always say that he's one of the greatest lyricists of our time.
All the way from the East Coast, Mr. Stephen Kellogg. I got all I ever wanted. But I still cannot believe
how I love to take for granted all the love that comes to me, all the love. So I'm just there to say thank you so much for your service. They're away from their families, right, for much more than we are as musicians. Yeah.
I've always kind of operated in different genres, so it gave me a chance to kind of indulge that.
After seeing that film about you, Last Man Standing, I have a new appreciation.
Do you remember who we were when all this began?
15 years.
I do this because I don't feel that I have an option. And it's also how I feed my family, so.
For me, music just has to say something. Gonna be the last man
standing. He has also written a book of corresponding essays about life, marriage, and music.
Writing the book is harder than I thought.
Yeah. I'm about to start work on a new project. A series of essays that correspond to a new book.
It's like I got four daughters. I want to see them grow up, and I want to dream new dreams.
I should just stop now. We got nowhere to go from there. You guys must be those in-person humans I've been hearing so much about. On the road again. I just can't wait to get on the road again. The life I love, it's making music with my friends, and I can't wait to get on the road again. On the road again. It feels real nice to be on the road again, seeing things that I may never see again. I can't wait to get on the road again. On the road again. Like a band of gypsies, we go down the highway. The best of friends, insisting that the world keep turning our way. Going our way. Looks like we're getting on the road again. This hotel, it makes me lonesome without you. There is marble and a fireplace, a panoramic view. And I know that you are serious when you said that we were through, but this hotel just makes me lonesome without you. I've been thinking about the man I thought I'd be. He had confidence, as I recall, and footlights dancing at his feet. But sometimes we sign up for ain't exactly what it seems. See, I've been thinking about the man I thought I'd be. And I guess somehow I got a bit distracted. But you deserve what I had promised from the start. And I should have read the memory of my failures and mistakes. But hey, so what? It opened up my heart. Now you got your amazing graces and your kids.
I've got aspens and a partial list of things I almost did, and I never will forget the way we took down NYC. I'm just not sure that memory is big enough for me. And I guess somehow I got a bit distracted, but you deserve what I promised from the start. And I should have read the memory of my failures and mistakes, but hey, so what? It opened up my heart. Hey, so what? It opened up my heart. Hey, so what? I've got an open heart. The stream is in a vacant hall. Familiar ghosts and blacked out calls. It breeds a bitter taste. Chattering of businessmen, smoke traces from the critics' pen. They slap you as they smile in your face. We've been passed by, or you know we've been passed up. Banged around till these paper hearts got tough. Oh, it's like a glass jaw boxer who fights for his life every night, like a shadow, an 11th hour hopeful with more than a mouthful. Then I'm not putting on airs. Why care about what you can't see? It's just a glass jaw boxer who fights for his life. Every night I'm fighting. Remember when we got high behind the house by the garage so the kids would not find out? The cat's on Prozac and no one seems to care. The party's packed but you feel like no one's there. We're born with everything you need, so wear that heart of yours on both your sleeves. You have got the best and worst of me, so wear that heart of yours on both your sleeves. Both your sleeves. Both your sleeves. Both your sleeves. My friends, now the thing is, there's a line in that song about the cat being on Prozac. I got to spend more time with my cat in the last 17 months than ever before, and I'm very thankful for the Prozac. And the very first night I went back out and started doing shows about 6 weeks ago, I went back out and I just did the show sort of local, and then I came home, and I guess I left the door open for just a minute. We have an indoor cat. And so it was about 2 a.m. when I got home, and I just had this feeling that maybe my cat, Holly, had gotten out. So I walked around the house a little bit, and I didn't see her. And then I went outside, and I went around the front of the house, and sure enough, there was my special needs cat, and it was 2 a.m. and I thought, this isn't good, because when I left, I thought Kirsten was like, well, I look forward to getting a good night's sleep and have fun. And I'm like, you're gonna miss me? She's like, just go, you go, stay as long as you need to. And I went off, and then I'm outside and I'm trying to coax the cat back in with we keep these really cheap treats, Temptations, you know, we keep these around for We go with the organic stuff when we can, but when we need to just get a fix, it's like the McDonald's for special needs cats. So I go out with the Temptations, and I'm holding it out there, and I'm like, come on, Holly, here you go. So what had happened was she'd gotten into the flowers, and she started eating flowers. So she just turns around and is like, just hisses right at me and starts walking away. And I realize she's like a drunk teenager out there. She's just kind of like, don't tell me what to do. So I'm trying to coax her in, and she looks at me, and then, like a drunk teenager, she starts throwing up in the mulch. So I go, I'm now at the front door, and I go and I check, and the front door is locked. But I'm very worried when I start moving towards her, she's moving towards the lawn, which is like where the forest is, and her behavior is so erratic and unpredictable that I think, like, I don't know how this is going to go. So I have to call my house. We have a landline, which I know is really with it. So I call the landline, but no one picks up until like the third time, and then Kirsten picks up, like, what? And I'm like, I'm out front. I've got Holly. She's throwing up and trying to get away. I need you to come down right now. And that's probably the first and last time I'll ever tell that particular story, but I just thought it might be nice. If you guys know the words, you sing along. Gonna choose sunlight. I'm gonna be kind. Bound to win a few fights before my time. Gonna make love now. Ain't the future bright? We're gonna be the last ones staying down tonight. We're gonna be the last ones. We're gonna be the last ones. We're gonna be the last ones staying down tonight. Make a difference, yeah. I'm gonna speak my mind. Even when my nerve fails, even in the dark times, I'm gonna count the blessings, celebrate the wins. We're gonna be the last ones to stay in there.
Last ones.
We're gonna be the last ones. We're gonna be the last ones standing tonight. Woo! We're gonna be the last ones. We're gonna be the last ones. We're gonna be the last ones.
Fire and wild and American. She burns it out, probably just because she can. And if I had a dollar for everything I should have said, I'd probably still be busted. I would throw it all away again, yeah. Lightning bugs light up all across the southern sky. Some guys get it all and they don't even need to try. I watched you roll away, you didn't even say goodbye. Now I hate the night, I'm guessing that's the reason why. This is my life on the 4th of July. It isn't much, but at least it's mine. So I got in my van and I ended up in Boston. I thought about my friends and how easily I lost them. I'd do it all again, I leave everyone exhausted. Some folks get a break, me I'll never call one. I thought of you nights when I would drink too much. If you thought about me too, you never tried to get in touch. Went back to school and I ran into these guys I knew. We started up a band, but we couldn't seem to get it through. We got some kicks and eventually we lost that too. You ever think that maybe if you're not happy, it's because of you? But this is my life on the 4th of July. It isn't much, but at least it's mine. So I got this job, I was selling ads for magazines. Nights I would play and I would think about her constantly. Everything I loved somehow got away from me. Suicide, used to talk about it openly. I finally quit, maybe I got fired, I don't know. Doesn't matter, just as long as it happened though. I added up the fears and the doubts I was living with. Songs of lightning bugs and school and work and all that shit, you know, and this. This is our life on the 4th of July. It is a bunch, but at least it's mine. just a girl, some time and a couple friends. Small talk and parties, I never could stomach it. I'm old enough to say, I remember when. But I don't have the time for the nostalgia or the criticisms you live and learn. See, I've been learning to let go of parents and bosses and people who don't want us to grow. I know that anything we want to, we could do. No one's gonna tell me just who I should be singing to. And this right here, it's our life. On the 4th of July. Oh, and it isn't so much. Yeah, but at least it's mine, and I know what's mine now. Baby, this is my life. On the 4th of July. And it ain't so much, but at least
thank you so much. Imagine if we just went like that all night. No, I'm gonna do this because I was reading this in bed the other night. It's The Plague by Albert Camus. And I said, you know, I think I might read this passage at the show. And my wife, Kirsten, said, you're not going to do that. And that's when I knew that I was definitely going to do that. So, here we go. Lock the doors. Nobody's leaving. Once plague had shut the gates down the gates of the town, they had settled down to a life of separation, debarred from the living warmth that gives forgetfulness of all. In different degrees, in every part of the town, men and women have been yearning for a reunion. Not of the same kind for all, but for all alike ruled out. Most of them had longed intensely for an absent one, for the warmth of a body, for love, or merely for a life that habit had endeared. Some, often without knowing it, suffered from being deprived of the company of friends and from their inability to get in touch with them through the usual channels of friendship. Others, fewer these, had desired reunion with something they couldn't have defined, but which seemed to them the only desirable thing on earth. For want of a better name, they called it peace. Thank you. No, I mean, you don't have to clap. I didn't write it. I'd be like, boy, Camus is really not big in Old Saybrook anymore. No, but what I was going to say is I hope that we can give you guys tonight some peace in being together. It's wonderful to see you shoulder to shoulder. And I know, you know, for us, when we parted ways last, we were in Belize, and Cookie and I were climbing onto a prop jet plane. We had just played a show, and we got on a prop jet plane.
No jet.
Yeah.
Just prop.
That's right.
Full on prop.
And Boots reminded me today. He said, you know, I didn't wake up because I was like, oh, I'll see you guys soon. You know, like you didn't get out of bed that day. You just
a year and a half later.
Yeah, a year and a half later. So. This song's called Lost and Found. It feels good to be found again. So.
A 1, 2, 3, and. It's not that I closed off my heart, it's just that I've gotten so tired. You're trying to find an easy way out, it gets so exhausting to keep you inspired. You can find me, you can find me at the lost and found. But don't be surprised, don't be surprised if I don't turn around. Find me at the lost and found. Sometimes a man gets worn thin, on the brink of a break of an almost there win. Never enough money from what I could see. A labor of love, man, you gotta be kidding me. You can find me, you can find me at the lost and found. But don't be surprised, don't be surprised if life don't turn around. Find me at the lost and found. Do you recognize me? I don't recognize you. And I don't know how we got here. I don't. Do you recognize me when you tell me it's through? 'Cause believe me, I don't recognize you. I'm not even sure if I think you should stay. It's like I don't know where to start. Do I set it on fire just to protect my heart? You can find me, you can find me at the lost and found. But don't be surprised, don't be surprised if one day it burns down. Find me, oh yeah, you could find me. You can find me at the lost and found. But you'd be surprised, you'd be surprised if you just look around and find me at the lost and found.
My vision of heroes, boy, did it change recently. You know, this last 17 months, boy, did you start to appreciate everyday heroes more than ever, you know? And, yeah. My friend Mark from the band OAR said, Stephen, the big thing is just don't, nobody wants to think about COVID. Don't mention anything about the last year. So I'll let them know I'm doing a really good job so far. But this is a song for all those everyday heroes that kept us rolling. It's called Orion.
Orion, I could see you looking down small houses that we built into the ground. At a distance, you can't see what's falling down. If you're up close, you can almost hear the sound of summer. I remember we would pack our things into the car, and though we never got too far, it's a wonder to discover how the winter finds its way to spring. Being young, man, everything in the summer. Constellations, are you laughing at us all? We rage as we watch our heroes fall. If they're up there, remember them to me, like my grandpa on the beach of Normandy. In the summer, we remember that Orion's sword is burning out. Lovers long forgotten, now there were mothers who discovered how the winter finds its way to spring. Your parents don't know everything in the summer. Oh, the stars are still the same. They see all of our pain. Oh, they can't do anything. And slowly they explode. Insecure, that's the trade-off. It's the cost of wanting more every summer. Remember to pack your things into the car, and if you never get too far, take a number. Discover you'll be doing what your parents did. Don't you dare forget it, kid. In the summer, we remember that Orion's sword is burning out. Oh, we'll be forgotten now in the summer.
Thank you so much. So, you know, part of every Kellogg show is a love song or two, because I want you to get lucky, you know. I want you to have positive associations you can create. I know that it's date night. You'll see we're making progress here with the fact that this show started at 7:30. I mean, and depending on, you know, I know there's a lot of good restaurants around here. I've noticed in middle age that what you order on a given night, it often determines your commitment to, like, what might happen later, you know? Like, if you order catfish, you've pretty much given up on romance. This has been a wild year for love, and, you know, for many, many, many years, it would always be like, oh, I love my wife, but I never get to see her. And then all of a sudden, we saw each other an awful lot this year, you know? And I was reminded of that when we got into a bit of a row the other night, which I know she's going to appreciate me telling you about, over the sponges, because we have two sponges, and one's red and one's blue, and she said, everybody listen up, just in that voice, because also she really likes when I refer to her voice like that. So she said, everybody listen up, the red sponge is for food, and the blue sponge is for counters. And I said, cool. So the red sponge, okay, it's pinkish. I'm like, that's like raw meat. And she's like, not raw meat. You can't use it for raw meat. But then I said, well, so what do we need? A third? Should we get a third sponge that's like the raw meat? And she was like, nah, now you're just being an asshole. And I'm like, no, I'm really trying. I said, should I use the counter the blue sponge seems like a worse choice for the thing. And so, and then she was like, really? And I said, I'm trying, help me understand. But also, we've never had a salmonella issue in our 27 years together. So I feel like it just needs me to go back out on the road a little bit and the whole sponge thing will just cool right out, you know? So, here's a love song for you. Well, the girls in California, they all look the same to me. The way they take for granted living by the sea. They could be your best friends if you don't expect too much. But the girls here in Connecticut, I heard they all believe in love, yeah. I met this girl named Liz in a bar just south of here. And she moved to New York City so that she could disappear. I told her she was beautiful and she thanked me for the words. But I will never understand just how he got through to her. But she moans in such a way that people fall in love with her every single day. I can't say I'm immune, though I've been trying to find you. And I know she's out there somewhere today. And the woman down the street from me, oh, she's got this daughter, 20 years, with a sun-kissed smile, the winter won't go near. Her hips could shake a mountain, and her lips could start a fire. And just like Nabokov, all these men walk by, as they do, they conspire. In such a way that people fall in love with her every single day. I can't say I'm immune, though I've been trying to cut on through all this lust and all this loving me, yeah. It's all right here, yeah. There's this girl from Greenwich. She just stopped me in my tracks. She tells me when I'm wrong, and she always makes me laugh. But of all the pretty women that I see every day, she's the only one who moans in such a way. She moans in such a way that I still fall in love with her every single day. And I can't say I'm immune, though I've been trying to show you, oh, that she could have my heart, that she could take my heart today. But darling, you could have my heart, you could just take my heart away, yeah. But then she comes and she lifts me up every single day, Lord. She's just like an angel. Like an angel. So this is a dance number. We didn't get to entertain much, like most of you who were following the rules. So it can't somehow. Each of my kids worked in people who they were like, well, they're in our bubble. I'm like, why? How? Did they? I'm like, I haven't seen one of my friends in 7 months, but like I have each of your friends in my bubble. Like I never really got it. But we did a lot of theme nights. We would do Wizard of Oz and Clue was one of the theme nights, and so or we'd have like a we did a semi-formal. I ordered corsages and boutonnieres, and we had a semi-formal. But we didn't have any of our friends. We just had their friends, and I knew we were really like it was going on because we were like, oh, I don't know. We should make sure Kate. Do we have the drink that Kate likes? Yeah, I think she's a Dr. Pepper girl. All right, let's get it. Like, you know, just like very much entertaining. And then they got there, and it was a big thing. And the happy thing is that the Kellogg's seem to attract people that dance, and I'm not trying to give you a hard time if you're like, Kellogg, I like you, but I don't dance. Like, that's okay. I just don't want to hang out with you that much if that's how you are. So here we go.
One, two, three.
If I don't leave a bank account, no plans had to proceed. If I don't give you what you want, I hope you get the things you need. Give my brother the guitars. Tell my sister sorry I lost touch. And tell my mama not to worry about money quite so much. Never turn your back upon a second chance. Never trust a guy who says he doesn't. I know you need to dance like a symphony of joy. And it's not your obligation to go easy on the boys. Cause the ceiling's gonna shatter, and believe me when it does, those who pin you to the margins, baby, they'll be sweeping up. Nobody's station to tell others how to live. But friends, we got a situation here where evil still exists. You can't turn away, you gotta have a dog in every fight. If you see one going rogue, don't back down just cause he bites. That's right, that's life. But you should drive him wild every time you get the chance. Honey, you got choices. Then I'm just not sure. You know you have, you're gonna dance like a symphony of joy. And it's not your obligation to go easy on the boys. Cause the ceiling's gonna shatter, and believe me when it does, those who pin you to the margin, baby, they'll be sweeping up. Don't turn your back if you get a second chance. And see, I don't trust a guy who says he doesn't. Everyone needs to dance like a symphony of joy. And it is not your obligation to go easy on the boys. Hell no, cause the ceiling's gonna shatter. And believe me when it does, those who pin you to the margins, baby, they'll be sweeping up and dance like a symphony of joy. You're gonna dance like a symphony of joy. Shout, oh, dance like a symphony of joy. Yeah, dance like a symphony, a symphony. Baby, you got the joy. Sha-la-la.
There's a very interesting collection of people here tonight. No, I'm not going to address that. That's sort of annoying.
Play something faster because that's what I want.
No, it's like, all right, cool. All right. What I was saying was it's a very interesting collection of people here tonight, and it includes, because I'm in my home state, a few significant... this isn't going to be a name game. There's just the reason I'm pointing out the people has a specific thing. So if I don't, not like talking about you and we know each other, is not a disrespect thing. It's just these are the people I've opted to discuss. I have this best coach ever mug, which I really appreciate the irony of it because I've never really been a head coach until this year. I coached a second through fourth grade co-ed soccer. I had to look up the positions about 30 minutes before the first game. And I said to my friend Rob, I said, I don't think I'm a good coach. And our record 2-7-1 bore that out. We lost a lot and I went home, but I did it. So he's here. That's just neat. You can clap, whatever, however, it's okay. Whatever you want to do. Coach K, yeah. They could see into my soul every game. I'm like, they know I don't know what I'm doing. I'm like, should I play midfield? I'm like, what's midfield again? Okay, got it. It's the middle of the field. Another person who's here is my contractor who got me to spend 2.5 times what I had intended to this year. So I let him buy his tickets tonight. I was like, yeah, you could swing it. Just take it out of that. I have my nutritionist is here who taught me that you're supposed to drink half of your weight in water every day, which is, it just seems ridiculous and totally counterintuitive to sort of what happens to the middle-aged body. And just like, it's just like, well, what, you're just up all night peeing. And I mean, it's just... And I'm jealous of like your Ed Sheerans and your Shawn Mendes because they have like show, you know, like the stage gets dark when you go to their concerts and there's like a light show for like 4 minutes. And I realize now what they're doing is they're taking a leak downstairs. They're like, okay, pee break. And that's how it goes. But we haven't reached there yet. But amazing nutritionist who I said, you know, I'm not trying to build a temple. I'm just trying to build a house that won't blow down in the wind. And can you help me sort this out? So that was great. And the last person here tonight is our presenting partner, my friend John from Bird Dog Whiskey, who every 3 months, a giant box full of booze would show up unsolicited on my doorstep. And John lives here in Old Saybrook. So John, thank you for presenting tonight. This is a song, a very sing-along sort of song to get pumped up for coaching. I would frequently put on AC/DC, and I would just need it to get like fired up for facing the kids. And I would come into the parking lot cranking Highway to Hell. And so I thought to myself, I need an AC/DC-like song where you know what the chorus, what that's gonna be about. So this is AC/DC for middle-aged people who like Americana music.
The one making a decision always ends up second-guessed by a person less decisive who believes that they know best. I wouldn't change a thing and I would make the call again. Shame on you, you could have been a friend. Now it's hard to hear the measure that was with me all the time, like it was in the beginning, but the past is hard to find. Do you think we'll ever feel the way we felt when we began? Do you think we'll ever feel that way again? Oh, those high highs and low lows, there's only one way that the river flows. Was it comedy or tragedy? both I would suppose, highs and low lows. Oh, that time in Arizona when we laughed until we cried, and all the sleepers in the van, they one by one turned on the lights. And I never hear the Beach Boys without thinking about that song. What a miracle to feel like you belong. Those were high highs and low lows. There's only one way that the river flows. Was it comedy or tragedy? Where did the good times go? It's high highs and low lows. To those high highs and low lows. Now when I received your letter, I hung my head and cried. I looked right into the mirror, and the mirror doesn't lie. I wrote 20 songs in Nashville. I wrote 20 in LA. 20 for those brothers that I lost along the way. But for every song I wrote, through every single note, I knew that I was writing songs just to give myself some hope. And I've scattered tiny rocks across an asphalt road for some reason. I just needed you to know about these high highs and low lows. There's only one way that the river flows. Was it comedy or tragedy? Where does the money go? It's high highs and low lows. To those high highs and low lows. If what she said about me, if I believed that that were true, I would throw myself upon the mercy of the ocean blue. But most of your critique, it doesn't sound that much like me. Though I wonder if it sounds a bit like you. Oh, those high highs and low lows. There's only one way that the river flows. Was it comedy or tragedy? Who really knows? It's high highs and low lows. To those high highs and low lows. We've had high highs and low lows. Drinking up alcohol to raise these kids, warts and all. There wasn't enough alcohol to quench my parents' thirst. And if I end up just like them, that's okay, ain't no sin. Where you going, where you been? It's mostly the same place. I got all I ever wanted, but I still cannot believe how I love to take for granted all the love that comes to me. We got enough words to write, books to read, we got fights to fight. There ain't enough of those thoughts and prayers to satiate my rage. And maybe we are just as bad as our worst enemies have said.
Or maybe we are just ourselves having an off day, yeah. I got all I ever wanted, but I still cannot believe how I love to take for granted all the love that comes to me, all the love that comes to me, all the love that comes to me. I dig the evening buzz, I hate the morning drag. I dig that evening buzz. And I don't sleep nearly enough, but I'm still happy because, yeah, I am still happy because, yeah. Cause I got all that I ever wanted, I got all I ever need, and I love to take for granted all the love that comes to me. You are all that I ever wanted, I still cannot believe how I love to take for granted all the love that comes to me, baby. You are all that I ever wanted, I still cannot believe how I love to take for granted all the love that comes to me, all the love that comes to me, all the love that comes to me.
So that song's about raising kids, and this next song's also a family song. You know, if you just to give you, people sometimes erroneously, you know, go, oh, Kellogg, you're a good dad, or, you know, and I'm not a bad dad, but I'm not, like, Kirsten had a girl's day about 3 weeks ago, and I was determined to like knock it out. I was like, we're gonna get the laundry. I overshot the mark is what I did. Instead of just like getting things done, I really tried. I was like, we're gonna have the house clean. So I thought, I did the little matrix of like soccer to dance, Uber driver kind of thing. I did that all day, really thought I had done a good job until my youngest daughter said, you know, Dad, do you have my lucky bracelet? And I didn't have her lucky bracelet. Which is an honest mistake as a parent, so that's not so bad in and of itself. The bad look is when you're like, well, you know, really, it's not my responsibility. I'm little truth bombs here, you know. And so then she's like, what? You're blaming me? And I'm like, well, you know, if this. And so right then, of course, Kirsten comes home, and I'm like down on the level, just arguing away, me and Greta in there, and so then I drove around. I went dumpster diving at Dairy Queen. I tried to find the lucky bracelet. And then I found out that they make lucky bracelets on Amazon. I'll tell you one more on this, because I just want to load it up so that you leave here really feeling good about the way that you parent and the kind of husband you are. Noelle was getting ready. She's 10, and she was getting ready, doing her assignment she'd been working on for a few days. And I spilled some champagne on it. It was on the dining room. Well, again, I'm qualifying, but I'm like, you know. So I spilled some champagne. She said, Dad, now it's going to smell like wine. And I'm like, not wine, honey. That's very quick. Oh, that's expensive French champagne. Your friends will be impressed, and your teachers will too. I am trying, and I hope these gals know that they're loved. So this one's called Song for Daughters, and it's for all you women out there, all right? Well, this is a song for our daughters, 'cause there's some things that they need to hear. We never know when it's our time to go, so let me be perfectly clear. You're gonna win and you're gonna lose.
You're gonna walk yourself round in your shoes till maybe one day it's you who will say. Don't be too hard on yourself. You don't have to be somebody else. On the days when you most wanna give up the ghost, don't be too hard. Don't be too hard on yourself. Girl, everyone wants to be beautiful. Everyone looks in the mirror and sees things they would change. They feel some sort of pain, but I see your beauty so clear. It's in a way that you light up when you are doing those things that you love. Just how you are, that's the best part. So don't be too hard on yourselves. You don't have to be somebody else. On the days when you most wanna give up the ghost, don't be too hard. Don't be too hard on yourself. And if Venus should smile down upon you, you're lucky enough to find love. Give it all that you got, 'cause good love takes a lot. And pray that that love is enough. And if it's not, how it can hurt. It's so much less than you deserve. If you're there one day, you'll hear me say, well, don't be too hard on yourself. You don't have to be nobody else. On the days when you most wanna give up the ghost, don't be too hard. Don't be too hard. So don't be too hard on yourselves. You don't have to be somebody else. All the days when you most wanna give up the ghost, don't be too hard. Don't be too hard on yourselves. This is a song for your daughters. Don't be too hard. Don't be too hard on yourselves.
Well, on that note, what if we were to bring a couple of my daughters out onto the stage to join us for a little music? So proud of these guys. I mean, they help me in my shows, but also they just they do a great job of not absorbing all my baggage. Like, they can kind of pinpoint when I'm like, I don't know if you want to play that sport. Are you good at it? And they're like, I just want to have fun. And I'm like, oh yeah, that's like one way you could approach things, you know. But I'm very proud of you guys. And I wrote this song years ago when my brother was heading off to college, with all the advice I kind of wanted to give him, I gave it to him as a gift, and I think I asked you one day when I was feeling like depressed about my own music, and I was like, what's your favorite song of mine? I mean, this is very needy stuff for a dad to ask their kid. But they picked this one, so we're going to sing it for you.
Well, it's hard to live in front of the world. There's only so much that you can pretend. Write down what it is you're thinking. Take each day as it comes. You never know what's hanging round the bend. And as far from the world as we get, I can swear that the two of us will always be the same. Figure out what it is you believe in, and if you must choose, try not to trade your fortune in for fame. And you'll learn wait your turn. And you get sick on the way by the things that people say. It'll break your heart against the wind, but you will just keep breathing in. If you're scared to live in front of the world, I've got news for you. You should be then. When your confidence gets low and you got nowhere to go, just remember how you felt about me and our friends, and we'll learn. Wait our turn. And we'll get sick on the way by the things that people say. It'll break our hearts against the wind, but we will just keep breathing in. Watch the way you fall in love. If you're smart, you take it slow. And don't ask me about it. I don't know. But I'm trying to learn. And I'm taking my turn. I get sick on the way by the things that people say, and it breaks my heart against the wind, but I will just keep breathing in.
Adeline Kellogg and Sophia Kellogg. You know, that's not all the Kelloggs. There's a couple more in the Kellogg sisters, and maybe we get them out here. You know, we're at that point in the show where I know you need a little jolt. So we're going to have you We're going to lead you in a dance. And you're going to, maybe some of you are going to be like, well, I feel uncomfortable. Well, sorry. It's all right. Let's show them the dance. It goes like this. Around and around and around and around. The Rocket Man and the Wall of Sound. Turn it up. Make it loud. Big Easy. Cool. You guys did a pretty good job. We got to work on this corner. And also, let's not forget about our streaming audience around. Thank you all who are streaming in. Do the dance. Tag us. Let's do it again. Let's show them again, because maybe this section didn't know. Around and around and around and around. The Rocket Man and the Wall of Sound. Turn it up. Make it loud. Big Easy. And an angel gets its wings. There we go. Yeah, she goes around and around and around and around. The Rocket Man and the Wall of Sound. Turn it up and make it loud, Big Easy.
Yeah!
Oh, girl. Girl, you're real pretty. And a guy like me is getting pretty late. There's no mistaking, you see the vows they've been taking. But a girl like you, you should never have to wait. And I've been searching, searching for a new dog. But nothing they would say could come from me. You let me come back, I'll make you a promise.
Come on now.
But a promise ain't no good if it won't keep. Yeah, it goes around and around and around and around. Rocket Man and a Wall of Sound. Turn it up, make it loud, Big Easy.
That's pretty good. That's pretty good. I'd say that was like 94% coverage, but I want the other 6. Maybe Addy can help us out.
Yeah, it goes around and around and around and around. The Rocket Man and the Wall of Sound. Turn it up, make it loud, Big Easy. Yeah, it goes around and around and around and around. The Rocket Man and the Wall of Sound. Turn it up, make it loud, Big Easy.
That's it.
In the shadows, in the light of day, are never what you might suppose. Reality, that's a wrecking ball that smashes everything you know. Yeah, yeah. There it goes. There it goes. Around and around and around and around. The Rocket Man and the Wall of Sound. Turn it up and make it loud, Big Easy.
Yeah!
She goes around and around and around and around. The Rocket Man and the Wall of Sound. I'm gonna turn it up. I'm gonna make it loud, Big Easy.
One more in Espanol.
Cerebuel, 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 de la astronave y poder oído. Lord Marcelto, el volumen payaso, Marci Grande!
Greta Kellogg, Noel Kellogg, Sophia Kellogg, and Adeline Kellogg, my offspring. Should have saved it for the very end, I guess. If I'd known a partial standing ovation was coming. We're going to do one more ballad before we move into the last motion of the evening. And this is... I know I've been talking a lot about parenting and raising kids, but it is... Before I was home for a year, I used to just come home at the end of a tour, and I would sit there and stare at them all, kind of creepy, but I just, like, look at them, you know. And I would often, you know, remember the point in the day where I was like, you know, I'm not your servant, you guys. And I would just be like, I want to do better. You know, I'm going to try again to do better. And it usually would fall apart by about 9:45 in the morning. But I wrote this song by way of just, you know, again, just hoping that they understand. It's a hard job. I read recently that people, I won't go to get into it. People. That was my indoor voice saying that.
Well, I'm happy, but I've got an angry heart. I live in a world so dark. Sometimes I can't see what's in front of me, and I get scared. Hey, darling, I notice that you're still sad. It's written on your forehead that you'll get no peace even when we sleep, and that's not fair. I wish you could see this light that surrounds you in the night, and I almost woke you up. Words could never be enough, and I always say too much, but I almost woke you up. You're so perfect since the day I met you. There was it I just knew. But how do we get well when we hurt like hell? Damned if I know. I wish you could see this light that surrounds you in the night, and I almost woke you up. Words could never be enough, and I always say too much, but I almost woke you up. Yeah, I almost woke you. We were taught, we were told that you cannot have, but you cannot hold. Yeah. 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 I wish you could see this light that surrounds you in the night, and I almost woke you up. Yeah, I almost woke you. Words could never be enough, and I always say too much, but I almost woke you up. Yeah, I almost woke you. Oh,
Soul. My mama says so. Says, son, you move up. You're a fighter, I know. You see, life isn't free, and everyone dies eventually. Gravity, you're knocking me out. You're shaking me up till I twist and I shout. Whoa, gravity, so can the clouds, but I love it right here with my feet on the ground. Y'all feeling good? One, two, celebrate before it's too late. Your fear of the future's your greatest mistake. There's a song, we sing it out loud, and ain't nothing as sweet as an in-person crowd. Alright, now gravity, you're knocking me out. You're shaking me up till I twist and I shout. Oh, gravity, so can the clouds, but I love it right here with my feet on the ground. I love it right here with my feet on the ground. Knocking us out, she's been shaking us up till we twist and we shout. Whoa, gravity, it's okay in the clouds, but I love it right here with my feet on the ground. I love it right here with my feet on the ground. And I'm singing, gravity, you're knocking me out. Oh, you're shaking me up till I twist and I shout. Whoa, gravity, so okay in the clouds, but I love it right here with my feet on the ground. I love it right here with my feet on the ground. I love it right here with my feet on the ground. I love it right here with my feet on the ground. I love it right here with my feet on the ground. And I love it right here with my feet on this ground. I love it right here with my feet on the ground.
Thank you all so much for coming tonight. We're going to do one more song for you. I want to thank the crew that sustained me through 17 months, Lee Totten, Jessica Martin, Shady Katz, and Dale Campbell. And also the tremendous crew right here at the Kate, Dennis doing the sound, Mike doing the lights, all this wonderful staff, the volunteers, Ayud running the stream. Thank you all for being a part of tonight. And thank you guys so much for trusting us and coming on out. So much has happened since I saw you last. I released a book, which I wouldn't recommend in a pandemic. It's like the wrong time to put a book out. So you got that. That's free advice. No extra charge for that. But I wrote my book, Objects in the Mirror, Thoughts on a Perfect Life from an Imperfect Person. It's a thank you both. Sounds like we got some work to do here in getting this book out there. I'm not hard selling you on anything, but I want to tell you what's out there because I know it's a pain. If you're anything like me, you're probably a little tired. Maybe some of you had catfish or whatever, and so you're like, oh, man, I just got to get back to the... But basically, we have a saying with shows, you know, if it feeds your bank account or your soul, if you can get both... That's a great night. If you can get one or the other, that'll do. And if you get neither, that's no good. This has definitely been a very soul-fulfilling show. But if you dig it, we have a lot of new merchandise out there. And I know it's a pain to stand in line for a minute, but it makes a big difference in our life. So there's four new T-shirts. You don't have to clap for that part. That's not the good part yet. The good part is we got four new T-shirts. This frisbee. Oh, it's nothing. We have this frisbee. We have onesies. If you're like, I didn't dig the music, but I know babies that need clothes, I'm your guy. We got vinyl. And we have a series of lyric boards of different lyrics that Noel and I painted together that are out there. They're all one of a kind. I think that's kind of what we have. We have my first tie-dye, which as a deadhead, I don't know why it took me so long, probably because they're really expensive to make. But Boots bought one online, and you bought two?
Oh, no, Peace Man.
Oh. I was like, God's grace, what kind of my bandmate if you bought two? No, so if you're inclined, please pay a visit. It makes a big difference. You've been such a wonderful audience. Thank you all so much for being here tonight. I've got to get back to the city, where the sound is the subway at night. People I see on the crowded streets, it helps me to feel more alive. And I have gotta get back to the country, where the sound is the song of the spring. Kids in the town running around, it helps me to feel like I'm free. This is my favorite place. My worry slips away. I could stay here for days and days and days and days and days. This is my favorite place. My worry slips away. Well, it's time I was getting back home, where the sound is a song in my heart. All the places I go, I always know. Home, it's wherever you are. And this is my favorite place. My worry slips away. I could stay here for days and days and days and days and days. This is my favorite place. My worry slips away. I could stay here for days and days and days and days, days and days and days and days.
places I go, I always know home is wherever. Home is wherever. Home is wherever you are. Home is where.
Someone walks in off the street right now, they'd be like, what?
Home is where. Home is wherever you are. Home looks like Old Saybrook tonight. This is my favorite place. My worry slips away, and I could stay here for days and days and days and days and days. This is my favorite place. It's written on my face. I could stay here for days and days and days and days. Days and days and days and days and days. This is my, this is my, this is my favorite place. This is my, this is my, this is my favorite place. This is my, this is my, this is my favorite place. This is my, this is my, this is my favorite place. This is my, this is my, this is my favorite place. This is my, oh, this is my, this is my favorite. This is my favorite place.
Thank you all very much. Thank you. We would be honored to play an encore. It's really hard to rush tonight because we've been waiting for it for 18 months. So we kind of had to load it up and just go for a while. And as long as you got Gatorade, I just have a couple more tricks up my sleeve. Is there a Jeff Katowski here? Jeff Katowski. Good to see you. I heard you wanted to ask your date something.
Woo!
It looks good, and she said yes. That's good. Congratulations, you guys. For those of you at home, these guys just got engaged, and Jeff sent us this lovely email, and he said it would be a dream to do this and then hear this song. And that at the same time, we got an email from another guy who said, I'll give you $500 if you play this other song. So it was tough to walk away from the money, but I'm glad we did. It was good. So here's your song, buddy. You were 16 and I was all white. You were Venus to Milo and Spud. You convinced me that I was okay. I convinced you that maybe you'd stay. And if I thought that you'd give up on me, I'd never say hello. But girl, you gotta know. Girl, you gotta know. We grew up and you grew away. But I'd follow you to my dying day. And all the guys that tried for your hand, they couldn't steal you from this desperate man. And if I thought that you'd give up on me, I'd never say hello. Girl, you gotta know. Girl, you gotta know. Girl, you gotta know. Girl, you gotta know. And this face that you see, well, you know it ain't me with this lack of resolve and will. It's like a dog that won't learn visions you can't discern. But you know me and you like me still. Oh, I don't know how, but somehow and I've grown enough. I'm not better, but I won't give up. And you're still here like a flower in rain. You get knocked down and you rise up again. And if I thought that you'd give up on me, I would have never said hello. Girl, you gotta know. Girl, you gotta know. Girl, you gotta know. Yes, you do. Girl, you gotta know. Oh, oh, and I sing it from my soul. I sing it, whoa. We'll be right back. Congratulations, you guys. We're really happy for you. I promise you this show is almost over, but I had other things than their engagement that I had wanted to say before you left, because I've been wanting to see you so badly for so long. This is a song that Eric and I wrote together, and sometimes you get to a place in your life and in your career where you think that maybe your best stuff is behind you, or you haven't, and it can be pretty, it can make you feel blue. And so if anybody out there is ever feeling like maybe you're, there was a point before now that was better, when you were really kicking ass, you were an Inc. 500 company and you were running it, or maybe you're still hungry for college because you just got lucky all the time and stuff like that, and maybe now you're like, why am I in pajamas every day for 400 straight days? Pajama land, welcome to marriage and quarantine. Pajama land. Anyway, I just wanted to play Pajama Land, and now that I have.
'76, day that I was born, right before my parents split, and it was hard, I know, on them. When you're young, raising children, as we look back through the looking glass, visions closer than they appear. Stubborn toes on toys, those days you wish were still here. There'll be objects in the mirror. '26, our eyes glued to school on a television set, but no one told us now. We knew that every dream does not come true. And as we look back through the looking glass, visions closer than they appear. Even when they say the sky above will be clear, there'll be objects in the mirror. '03, the day I said goodbye to my favorite refugee, and if he came to us again, would we even let him in? '13, 2012. The last day I remember Mama acting like herself, and when the angels took her home, I was never so alone. And as we look back through the looking glass, vision closer than they appear. When you're holding on to the hope of one more year, well, just objects in the mirror. '10, 2, '17. Terror in Las Vegas and the ghost of Tom Petty and all these big guns and bad hands. They cannot bring back one good man. And as we look back through the looking glass, visions closer than they appear. But if fear itself, if it's the only thing we should fear, then what of these objects in the mirror? Back here on this stage, and we've only just begun. It's a hard year that we just passed, but it's only love that lasts. So as we look back through the looking glass, visions closer than they appear. There's so many things to be grateful for, my dears. All these objects in the mirror, objects in the mirror.
Thank you all for coming out on a Thursday night, making this grand introduction so wonderful. It has been an honor and a pleasure to my family. Thank you for all that you do. And we will not say goodbye. We will just say see you later, see you soon, until we see you again. Was shot through with adrenaline to fire up my excited heart, help me believe in myself and get the starter to start. 15 burning balls of fire, 10 days since we left. No one understands me like a whiskey on my breath. It's 10 minutes to showtime. Baby, stop your crying. Everybody knows why. Well, there's just no time. Yeah, alright. See you later, see you soon. See you later, alligator and I will see you in the moon. See you later, see you soon. See you later, alligator and I will see you in the morning. You got a suicide club on a mission, so they hate their jobs and our guys. Everything is tougher than it has to be, another cliche from the wise. And somewhere east of that solo and a little bit west of the bridge was a singular kind of moment you remember as long as you live. And sometimes when it's just before showtime, well, I swear I might end up crying. Just letting go of my fears and my landlords, that's the difference between living and dying. See you later, see you soon. See you later, alligator and I will see you in the moon. See you later, see you soon. See you later, alligator and I will see you in the moon.
we'd pretend to be pirates. And talk about starting up a band. But the older we all got, the more that we forgot. Greed and treasure, they go hand in hand.
Sing with us, come on.
See you later, see you soon, come on. Never know, dear, how much I love you. Please don't take my sunshine away. And you're still out of here by 9:30. This is good, God-fearing, middle-aged fun we had tonight, everybody. I want to say see you later, see you soon to the great Eric Donnelly on mandolin, pedal steel, guitar, and vocals. Just without Eric, I just was like, what? See you later, Jason Wexler. It's such a trick to have you on the keys, brother. The fella I recorded this song for the first time with 20 years ago, my Gene Simmons, Mr. Cookie Dough Chowfan on the bass. Everybody. An oldie but a goodie. No words for how special it is to play music with people decade after decade, and I'm just so incredibly grateful for the day that you came over to my cabin up in Southampton, Massachusetts, and I insisted we only play 70s soul songs, which now seems a little pretentious, but it's such a treat, man. On the drums, Mr. Boot Factor. So we're going to sing this chorus two times, and then we're going to go off into the world, and I'm wishing you so well. Just, if you wouldn't mind, sing it with me, and then
Don't stop clapping till I'm off stage. See you later, see you soon. See you later, alligator, and I will see you in the moon. That's it. See you later, see you soon. See you later, alligator, and I will see you in the moon. Let's just do two more, that's it. See you later, see you soon. See you later, alligator, and I will see you in the moon. Just two more, I promise, that's it. See you later, see you soon. See you later, alligator, and I will see you in the moon. That's right. See you later, see you soon. See you later, alligator, and I will see you in the moon. Thank y'all very much. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.